to keep away from you. But you just step off the light, and I am
Hello, my name's Van from Catfish and the Bottlemen. You're watching enemy.com and this is the tale of Cocoon. I went over to New York and I was like 21 and it was like the first time in my life I'd ever been like proper like fucking for real, do you know what I mean? 21 and in New York ringing my dad from this mad apartment and that, and I was writing out there and I was out there like writing tunes with people and I kind of got these two tunes together and one of them was Hourglass, which is on the album, and one was Cocoon. And I started writing it on based on, like, I was on this balcony just having a smoke overlooking like the whole of New York, and I was kind of like, I want a song that kind of feels the way this looks, like this size, you know what I mean, like an enormity, and a song about, like, I just got to New York just by writing songs in my bedroom, you know what I mean, like, my dad had never been in there and been to New York just based on something he'd earned, and my mum and dad, you know what I mean, so... First time I'd wrote a full song with a mid late and stuff, because Neil, like our manager, used to always say to me, you know, because all our songs used to be like Catherine, like 2 minutes short, never had any mid lates or solos in, and I just thought mid lates and solos just got in the way of the third chorus. I thought it was what, you know, Ronan Keating did to ruin his songs, you know what I mean? Like, and they were always the bits in songs, so it was the first time I'd ever wrote my first ever mid late, and I like that mid late, so yeah, I think it's probably my favourite song off the album as well. It's the one that got on FIFA. It's the best, that's the best thing. That song gave me the most joy out of any song ever by getting on FIFA. That was it. That was my single, at the moment, favourite thing that's ever happened to me in a band, you know. When we're playing live, I don't even think about songs or set lists or what I'm singing, really. It's just about atmosphere. When you strip it back down to this kind of set where I'm playing the instrument I was writing the songs on, you've got kind of nowhere to hide with it, and it's kind of, you just hear everyone's parts for what they are, what everyone's written.
And I think it's more like, it's all just about the songs then, with 100 people stood like by your feet. Like, for me, I find it more intimidating. So I'll be sweating today, but...
You can think about music for as long as you want, but I think we think about playing live more, so everything that is written is to add to the set list and take out and hear people singing them back, and we've always just wanted to write the song and get them out and see how people react to them. It's the biggest thing we've done in London, and the tickets have flown. It's like 35,000, 30,000, something like that. Yeah, nice. So I'm classing that as a little stadium run, me. And they're always our favourite shows when there's no roof on the building. You can see as far as the burger vans. It's full of people. It's a big outdoor circus. I like them when it's a full
One day festivals are kind of my favourites, really. I've never been to one in Finsbury Park. Our drummer, Bob, he lives down in London now. He runs around it every morning.
Yeah, so 5 minutes running, so he's been with the never before.
I know, I said you can't run that morning, mate, it'll be shut. We're closing it down for the night.
But